Hello, I'm Mike, and today we're getting into something rather special in the world of AI, MCP, which stands for Model Context Protocol. In this video, I'm going to give you 6 examples from easy all the way to hard at the end of the video. For instance, it can read files on your computer, connect to things on the internet, remember everything, and much, much more. MCP is a common language for all AIs to be able to request information and complete actions. There's just one protocol to rule them all. Yes, Lord of the Rings fans, I really did go there. Okay, now you know what an MCP is and why you need one, let's see how we can use them. Now, I'm going to link this down below. And by the way, there'll be deep tutorials in the premium area of my community, which is also linked down below in the description. We're going to get started with something even simpler than that. We're going to install this MCP installer, and we're going to do it inside Claude, meaning once Claude has that one thing installed, you'll never need to install another MCP server again. And seeing as some of them can be quite complex to install, let AI do the hard work. Couple of prerequisites here. You'll need Node installed. Just do a search with AI to find out exactly how to do that. It's pretty simple. And then you'll also need the Claude desktop app and to be logged in. Okay, that's easy. With Claude all set up on my desktop, I'm going to run this command on my Mac, which will be in the notes I link, and then I can edit this file here. You'll see there's nothing in it right now, but I'm going to copy and paste this one MCP server, which is called MCP installer. With that done, we'll exit out of this by hitting Control X and Y. Now that I've done that, no tools have been activated yet. I simply need to restart Claude Desktop to see my first MCP tool. Okay, with that done, you might notice a subtle difference. Yes, I've got 2 MCP tools available. Now, if I click there, you'll see it's installing a local MCP server or installing a repo MCP server. And for the first example, I've chosen the file system MCP server as it's hosted by the official Model Context Protocol GitHub. So essentially, it allows you to read, write files, create lists, move files, search files, basically do anything on your local computer's hard drive. So pretty cool, but pretty complex instructions. Don't worry, we can make it easy now with Claude. All I need to do is copy this specific name of the MCP server I want. Then I go to Claude and simply say install and then paste in the name of the MCP server I want. Claude will have a think and then it's going to ask me to run my first MCP tool, MCP installer. So of course I allow, I can inspect what it's going to do first. And yes, of course, it's going to install the file system server. So I'll allow that once and in just a moment, we should have that installed. Easy as that, it says it's been successfully installed. Now please restart the app to start using it. So every time I need to restart Claude Desktop, but I should have now my file system available to me inside Claude. And what do you know, within moments, Claude has refreshed, and look, I've got 13 tools available. It can do so much on my computer's hard drive. I'm kind of blown away by that. So let's ask a follow-up. Look in my downloads folder and describe each thing that is there. And here it's got a description of everything in my downloads folder. Let's just pop this up here so we can see it's accurate. It looks like it is. And yes, look at this. Everything that's inside my downloads folder, including hidden files, are also there as well. If you like what you see so far, throw a like, subscribe for more videos just like this. I do them weekly. Let's install another MCP server. This time I'll just say install Puppeteer MCP server, please. And hopefully, Claude will get the context. I don't even need to give the repo address or the public URL. It'll just go and find it and install it for me. And then we're back in with now 20 tools available, including, you should see, Puppeteer, which gives you the ability to click, fill, and view, and hover, and do all kinds of cool things on websites. So you could fill out forms, you could book a whole holiday using Puppeteer. Essentially, it's remote control for browsers. We're going to use it in a really simple way, though. We're just going to put in visit and summarize this website. Now, you'll see here it actually says that Claude cannot access links, but oh no, it can using MCP. As I've added on the Puppeteer MCP, we should just be able to run that prompt, and in just a moment it'll come back and analyze the website for us. We allow this, it's going to visit the website, and look at this, now it's asking to take a screenshot, and now it's done. Look at this, everything that's on the website is being summarized here by Claude and has been done really, really accurately. That was using a web browser, which Claude now has access to, thanks to the brilliant MCP. That's not everything. I found a YouTube MCP server, so we'll say install this and then get Claude to install that for me. With that complete, I can now bring in the latest YouTube video from my other YouTube channel, copy the URL to that video, paste it into Claude. Again, it tells me that Claude cannot access links, but I'll say, tell me about this video. And now it's actually retrieving what was said in the video. And look at this, it's nailing it. It's talking about my Notebook LM and Wondercraft podcast enhancement video. And it's actually a great video. It's all about using Notebook LM to summarize content from the internet, turn it into a podcast, and then with Wondercraft, you can actually go ahead and edit the audio and even change the voices and the script and stuff like that. So if you want to watch that video, I partnered with Wondercraft to make it. It's a great AI tool, and I'll link the video up down below. All right, on to some more advanced use cases for MCP servers using Cursor, my AI no-code tool. And I'm actually going to open up the directory MCP example. You just have to click on the settings cog, which is up here in the top right, and then select MCP. And then you can add your first MCP server. Now, we're going to start off by doing maybe a search with Brave. So let's type in Brave here as the name. We're going to leave the type as command. And now this is where we need to insert the command to run, which again will be linked in my community down below. Oh, and by the way, if you haven't signed up to the Brave Search API, go and do it. You get 2,000 free queries every month. So it's a brilliant tool to have in your MCP arsenal. It's a very simple command, click add, and look at that. We've got Brave, green light, Brave web search, and Brave local search now working inside Cursor. Okay, we're going to do something really meta here inside Cursor. Because it's an OP tool that can create pretty much anything you can think of, in the Cursor chat, I'm going to ask it to do a search for info on MCP servers, then create a directory listing the best. Oh, and always add this, make it look really pretty. Okay, let's hit enter and let Claude 3.7 Sonnet go to work. And straight away, look at that. It's asking to call the Brave Web Search MCP tool. We can pop it open just to see that it's searching for MCP servers and info. So we'll just run the tool. And Cursor now has access to the internet when it's creating its directory. Now, you see, it didn't just do one search. It's asking to run another search. I can pop it open and we can see, yes, best MCP servers. And it's searching again. So this is agentic now because it's searching many times until it finds all the info it needs to make that beautiful directory. And now you can see it's coding an HTML page, and I can be part of the gang starting up MCP server directory websites. Okay, we're done. If I drag in a web browser and then drag and drop the web page in, look, top MCP servers directory. What is an MCP? Along with listings here for Amazon, Google, Airtable, and more. And I guess if I click a link, it's actually going to take me straight to the page with, yes, the sample MCP server from Amazon Web Services. How cool is that? If I wanted to hop on a trend, there you go. It's as easy as that to do so. If you're enjoying what you see so far, throw a like, subscribe. I do these videos weekly. Next up, I'm going to install Puppeteer inside Cursor, and I'm going to show you exactly how I do this. I go to the MPX instructions, and again, I'll simplify this in the community linked down below, but I just simply copy the name of the server here. I go back to Cursor, get rid of this chat box and look more at the MCP tab in settings, and I'm going to add a new server, and this time I'm going to call it Puppeteer, like so. And then for the command, we do npx-y, and then the name of wherever that server is. So model context protocol /server-puppeteer. Click add, and within a moment, it goes green. Yes, that's right, down here, we have Puppeteer installed with, as you'll see, a bunch of actions that can be done across the internet. Let's go ahead and test this one out. Now, just to make sure we don't confuse the agent, I'm going to actually uninstall Brave now, so it can only access Puppeteer, and then I'm going to open up the chat here with Cursor, and I'm simply going to type clone the site Hacker News. Now, we'll wait to see what happens here, but it's already saying I'm going to create a clone, and it's calling the Puppeteer Navigate tool here in order to look at the site. So it's not just using what's in the model's memory, it's actually going to take a real look at the site in order to clone it. Now it opens a website, looks at Hacker News. Okay, this is coding away, it's already done the index, and now it's doing the Hacker News styling. And with that done, it seems to now be complete. And it's told me that everything's ready. So I'll just accept the changes. I don't need to review them. Let's bring my web browser over here and let's drag in the index file. And wow, look at that. Actually, that's pretty much exactly what Hacker News looks like. It's created me pretty much an exact clone here of Hacker News. That is incredible. And just for reference, this is the real Hacker News website. And this is the website that Cursor just created using that awesome MCP server. Okay, then finally, we're going to end up with something that's rather more complex. Quite a few instructions here, but if you want to get deep in the weeds, stick around for this one. We're going to install a Qdrant MCP server. So Qdrant is essentially a database where you can store things, and it's really good for AI because it can do RAG, retrieval augmented generation, meaning the AI can kind of reach out for pieces of information to answer a question. In fact, I've done videos before about how I made AI Mike for my community that answers questions based on everything I've said in my YouTube videos, and that uses a Qdrant database. So let's get to it. First of all, you're going to need Docker installed, so make sure you have it installed. It's easy to install on pretty much any system, and make sure you get it up and running in the background. This will allow you to run a Docker container on your computer. So I'm just going to create a volume for Qdrant like so, and all of these notes will of course be linked for you to try out so you don't need to remember everything. Then I'm going to run this command to spin up something with a super safe password here, your password here of course. Oh, look at that, it is complete. So now we'll create a database using this quick API call, and it says true, it's done. And finally, just to make sure that the database is there, we're going to do a little ping to it. Let's clear the screen and do this. And yes, we can see status is green. That's all we need to know, status is green. Essentially, with those quick commands, I've set up a Qdrant database that we can now use our Qdrant MCP server on and maybe get Claude to store and remember things for us. So far, so good. Now I'm back here on the GitHub repo, and this is exactly how to use it with Claude Desktop. Then I'm going to paste it in, remembering to put a comma after my last server, otherwise it won't work. Save. Don't forget a few more credentials when you do this, that super secret password that I was showing you earlier, your password here, and my collection name that I created on the fly. We're also going to need to clone the server from Qdrant there, and then run this UV command. When that's done, we can restart Claude. Now I've trained all the data of my YouTube videos into this database, so I can say, what did Mike say about MCP on his recent videos on YouTube? Hit enter, the MCP tool is called, and here it comes back. MCP transforms the sandboxed AI into something that can do things with various tools. I demonstrated Replicate and Flux, and I also had a second example with Klein AI extensions for VS Code as well. Now, if you can't get enough of MCP, I'm partnering up with Zapier next week to connect everything to Cursor using Zapier and MCP. Make sure you're subscribed for that one. I really hope you've enjoyed this one. If you have, throw a like and subscribe as well, as I do these videos weekly, and I will have all the MCP server setup details in my community linked down below. Thank you so much for watching. And if you maybe want to share your thoughts on MCP and what you're really digging right now, just drop a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. And there's a video on your screen now that you should watch next.